This conference will now be recorded.
Hello guys, welcome to Kumar Consulting. So guys, in this session I'm going to cover another error. Let's have a look into error first. So look at here guys, the error is like account, this one already exists. Does not exist means already exist. And here the message number, it will be like this. Already exist. Look at here guys, I'll show you the error message, how it is going to look like. This was shared by one of my students. So here, look at here, account number, this one already exists. Case, whenever you're going to create, this error has taken place while setting up, look at here, the customer master. So if you set up any customer master, if you set up any vendor master, sometime what happens guys, you receive such kind of error. It means the error got generated once you, let's suppose you have given all the details and once you are going to save the customer master or vendor master, then what will happen? System is going to throw this error that account so and so, a particular number already exists. It means this is the customer number. Now this is already exist. So in order to understand, first of all, in order to see the solutions at all, try to understand how this customer numbers are getting generated. Customer numbers are getting generated. So guys, here what is happening, whenever we are going to set up a customer master, so customer master or vendor master, it is always getting created against a particular account group. First of all, look at here you have to select the account group. Let's suppose the account group which I am going to select, TM11. Okay, so here account group, double click. So it is getting created against a particular account group. Okay, once you give all the details, in the sense, once you are going to give all the details, you are giving customer number, sorry, customer name and address, and apart from this, multiple other details are there in company code data, like reconciliation account number, terms of payment, dunning and XYZ, whatever the details are there. After giving, the moment you are going to save the customer, then system will generate a customer number. System is going to generate a customer number or vendor number, right? So at the time of generating this customer number and or vendor number, what is happening? You are going to receive such kind of error. Which error guys? Account, this one does not exist, in the sense already exists. So it's already exist. So what is happening, whenever you're going to save this customer, system is, how the customer number is getting generated guys, or vendor number is getting generated, and I told you that this is getting, customer or vendor numbers are getting created against a particular account group. So what will happen, you just have a look here, I have already created, let's suppose OBD2, by this customer account groups are going to be set up. So here if you have a look, not OBD2, just go to OBAR. So what is happening, first of all, whenever you are going to save a customer, system is going to generate a customer number, right? So customer number, where it is coming from guys, customer numbers are coming from a particular number range. Customer numbers are coming from a particular number range. Say for example, how to define customer number range guys, XD N1. So here look at here, multiple number ranges has been set up already by different people, several number range has been set up, right? So now this number range, first of all, number range is going to be set up, and this is going to be assigned against your account group itself. Just have a look here guys. Now let me close this one. Now so here, this is our account group, right? So this, against this account group, which number range I have assigned? I have assigned number range 01. Look at here, the number range 01, this one I have assigned, right? And what is the range I have given? 100 to 109. Okay, it means whenever the customer number is going to be generated guys, the customer number will be from this range only. This is a very smaller range which I have given guys. Generally in real time what is happening, a very big range will be there, that is not possible to consume. It means unlimited you can save, right? Those many customers are not going to be set up. So From this range itself, what is happening, guys? The customer number is getting generated. Okay, so as I told you, like whenever you're going to set up a customer, the customer is getting set up against your a particular account group. So first of all, system has triggered the account group, and against that account group, which number range code we have assigned, guys? So against that particular account group, we have assigned a number range code that is 01, and against this 01, which number range has been set up, guys? So it is 100 to 109. So from this range only, 100 to 109, one customer one number is going to be generated. But at the time of generating the number, system is going to search one more thing. Here number is status. Okay, here what is the number in status? It shows 104. 104 means till 104 already the customers are created. It means how many customers are already created, guys? The customers 100, 101 102 103 until 104, this many customers are already created. So if the next customer is, once you save the details, so what should be the next customer number, guys? So whatever the number is there in number and status field, whatever the number is there in number and status field, guys, so here 104 plus 1, so the next number will be 105. But at the time of generating this 105 number, customer number, what will happen in background? System is going to check whether this number is already, with this number, any customer is already existing in the database or not. If there is no any customer, then only system is going to generate this number. Okay, if already any customer has been created with this number, then system is not going to generate this number, because for every customers one unique, this is called identification code, guys. So one unique identification code is going to be generated. And if you guys are able to understand, customers are getting created at client level. General data of the customer master is available at client level. Okay, so now here what is happening now, I'll explain the reason of this root cause of this errors and all. So generally what is happening, guys, we are using online server, or sometime what is happening even in offline server also it may appear. So what is happening, there are multiple people practicing in this group, and there are some people who keep on making experiments. So sometime what happened, somebody, just for the experiment, they have clicked number in status. Okay, number in status, and here by mistake, knowingly or unknowingly, what is happening, they are going to reset the number in status. Reset means they have deleted. Okay, they have deleted, and now let's suppose they have saved it. They have saved it. Okay, now if you click on back button here, and now if you click on internal, then what is happening, guys? Number in the status become zero. Number in status become zero. So in that case, what will happen, guys? Now if we are going to set up a customer master right now, so look at here, once again, XD01 I'm going to do. If we are going to set up, okay, you have to select your account group here. So I have already selected here, like TM11. Okay. Now, if we are going to select, if you're going to create a customer here, let's suppose I'll give a dummy name here. Only required details I'm going to give. Reconciliation account, that's it, and I'll save it. Control S. If I save it, look at here, account 100 already exists. Why system is showing this error? Because once I am going to save this customer, then system is going to check this customer is getting created against which account group, and the answer is account group is, where is that, guys? It's here, TM11. Okay, against TM11, which number range is there? 01. And against this 01, what is the range has been given, guys? Then the range is, so the range is 100 to 109, and then system is going to check the number in status. Number in status is zero. So what will happen, guys? As per this logic, system is going to generate the document number, that is the first number, smallest number, 100. So system is trying to generate customer number as a 100. But at the same time, in background also it is searching, in database also it is searching whether any customer is already existing with this number. System found up, of course, already the number is already occupied in the sense it is already created. A different customer master is already existing with the same number, right? So you are going to get this error that account 100 already exists. It means this customer number is already created. Why? Because I've told you here that earlier number status was there 104, right? It means till these many customers are already created. If you are going to now, so what will happen, guys? If you press enter, it means exit. And if you come back here, if you come back here and click on back button, and again, so look at here, now number and status automatically updated by system that it is 104. It means till 104 already the customers were created. It means somebody has, what they have done, they have reset the number status. If you reset the number status, then what will happen in such cases, you'll be receiving such kind of error messages, because if you're going to reset the status, it means system is going to consider zero as a number status. So what will happen, guys? Now once again, system is going to start following this sequences 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, right, 105. So in that cases, now once again, if you are going to set up this customer XD01, now the next 100 is already searched by system and that is already existing. Now again, system is, what will happen, guys? System is going to search now next one. If you see 101, look at here, it means till 104 the same error messages you will be receiving, and then system is going to generate the next number 10105. Instead of doing that, and might be in your cases, might be after, like, let's suppose 105, 104, till 104 you have to create, right? After that also there is no guarantee, because this is not the actual number. There might be chances that 105 is also existing, right? So again, in that cases, what you have to do, simply better not to make more experiments and all, you have to create a new number range. Okay, but here, look at here, multiple number range is already created. If you are going to set up a new number range, then you'll be having again issues of overlapping. Let's suppose I'm going to set up a new number range like here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, I'm going to create 12, right? And I'm going to give 300 to 3999. Press enter. Look at here, enter interval without overlap. It means whatever I'm trying to set up, this is overlapping with a different number range. What is this overlapping issues, guys? It's quite simple. Let's suppose I've created already, I have given a range 1000 to 1999, and if somebody is trying to create a different one, like let's suppose 1500 to let's suppose 2500, it means whatever range we are going to give, this is overlapping with this range, because here also 1500 till 1999 is the part of this one also, right? So this is going to be overlapped, right? So here you'll be having that issues also. So instead of that, I'll suggest you guys better to use a standard number range, which is 02. Better to use this 02 and all, or different number range. Instead of 01, we can assign a different one like 02 or any other number range. Okay, so here I'm going to use, let's suppose 02, and save it. Okay, now try to set up XT. Even the same thing will be there in the case of vendor also. Okay, in case of vendor also, you'll be having similar error, and the same solution is going to be applicable. You just click on company code data, give your reconciliation account number and save it. Look at here, now customer, this one has been created, 365, right? 100365. In this case also, what is happening, whenever we have saved, whenever we have created this customer, guys, system is going to check the account group. Account group is TM11. Against TM11, which number is now I have assigned, guys? So 02. And against this code 02, what is the range, guys? This is the range, right? And in that, look at here, guys. So NR status is also going to be searched by system. NR status is also going to be searched by system, and based on that, What is happening? Where is the customer number? Here the customer number is generated, and the moment customer number is getting generated, look at here, it is automatically system is going to update. Automatically system is going to update the new customer number. New customer number. Okay, so that what will happen if we are going to set up a new customer, again next customer, system is going to check the NR status. Okay, and it will be system is going to check the NR status, and what will happen guys, then the next customer is going to be generated, that 365 plus 1 366 will be there, right? This is what the logic behind. So in case if you are going to receive such kind of error, it's quite simple guys, better to change the number range and try to set up the customer or vendor, okay, whichever master data is there. So that's all in this session guys. Thanks for watching.